everyone, welcome back to another lesson. Today's learning goals are I can use substitution to evaluate algebraic expressions given values, and I can write algebraic expressions for verbally described expressions or real world context. Today we're really going to be just focusing on just the verbally described expressions, and we'll work on the real world context, I can say that word, later on in a different lesson. But to begin with, we have two expressions here. Both of them are negative 3 squared. However, one of them has the negative 3 in parentheses, the first one, and then the other one has the negative outside with the 3. Here, this one right here, this negative 3 squared with the parentheses, this means negative 3 times negative 3. Okay. That's because this square applies to everything inside this parentheses, so everything in here gets squared. So negative 3 times negative 3, as we know, is positive 9. Here, this negative right here is not the same. It is on the outside, per se. Just like how when we have negative 2x plus 3, we treat this as a negative 1, right? We treat this negative right here just like a negative 1. We say we're distributing a negative 1 into both of these. In the same way, here, this is like a negative 1, okay? So here, we have negative 1 times 3 times 3. Okay, and here we know this is negative 9. So remember, when the negative sign is not inside of parentheses with the, if there's a square right here, this square only applies to this 3. Okay, and then we use that negative like it's a negative 1. So the square only applies to this 3, not to this negative. It has to be inside parentheses in order for the square to apply to the negative as well. That being said, as a result, these two are going to have two expressions are going to have different answers when you evaluate them. So here, this negative 4 squared becomes 16 because negative 4 times negative 4 is 16 minus 7, which we know is 9, as opposed to the other side. Here we have negative 1 times 4 times 4, which is negative 16 minus 7, which gets us negative 23. Okay, so here it says consider a squared minus b in parentheses minus parentheses 2ab. It says if a equals negative 1 and b equals negative 2, what is the evaluated expression? So notice how a is being squared. Okay, we treat this a squared is going to be like negative 1 squared with the parentheses, because a is being squared, all of a is being squared, and all of a includes that negative number, the negative 1. So, as a result, what we can write is this, parentheses negative 1 squared with the negative 1 in parentheses minus 1 in parentheses minus parentheses 2 times negative 1 times 1. When we evaluate it further, that negative 1 squared turns into a 1. All of this right here we can do in one step because it's all multiplication and it's pretty easy. So 2 times negative 1 is negative 2 times 1, which is still negative 2. Then we have to continue evaluating what's in parentheses. 1 minus 1 is 0 minus negative 2. And as we know, when we're subtracting, we got to do keep, change, change, or change the subtraction into an addition problem, which means we're going to be changing this subtraction and the number after it. As a result, we get 0 plus 2 and 2 as our final answer. Part 2 says if a equals 1 and b equals negative 1, so they're flipping them now, what is the evaluated expression? Go ahead and try this one out on your own. What you should have found is that the final evaluated expression is 4 because 1 squared is still 1. And then we again can still do the 2ab is going to be the same thing, which gets us negative 2. Then we have 1 minus negative 1, which we know is 2. 2 minus negative 2 is the same thing as 2 plus 2, which gets us 4. Excuse me. Which gets us 4. Okay. The next question says, will the expression 2ab change when the values of a and b switch? Why or why not? Well, what we found was that it didn't, right? It didn't because No, because the multiplication is commutative. That means that it doesn't really matter what order you do the multiplication in. It's going to get you the same answer as long as the numbers are exactly the same, and that is all multiplication. Okay? Thus, 2 times negative 1 times 1 will result in the same thing as 2 times 1 times negative 1. All the same thing. Doesn't matter what order you do it in. Will the expression a squared change if a equals negative 1 or a equals 1? Why or why not? Again, the answer will be, as we found, to be no. Because negative 1 times negative 1 is 1, since the negatives cancel each other out, just like 1 times 1 equals 1. Because remember, when we have multiplied two negatives together, they cancel each other. I did not make my bed. So these two cancel each other out, so we get 1. Here. It says expression 1, add 3 to, consider these two expressions, add 3 to x, subtract the result from 1, then double what you have, add 3 to x, double what you have, then subtract the result from 1, or subtract 1 from the result, excuse me. So, when we try this out, when we write out the first one, the first part says add 3 to x, so we're going to do 3 plus x, and it says subtract the result from 1. So that means that we're taking 1 and subtracting what we have. So we're going to do 1 minus, and we're going to subtract all of it. Because if we don't, we're only subtracting the 3, and we're not subtracting the x as well. Then double what you have. Well, what we have is right here. So we're going to double it, which means we're going to multiply that by 2. Go ahead and try expression number 2 out on your own. What you should have found is that it was 2 times parentheses 3 plus x minus 1, because we have to add 3 to x just like we did last time, then double what you have. So what we have is 3 plus x, so we're going to double it, multiply it by 2, and we have to multiply the entire thing by 2, because we have what we have is the entire thing. Then we subtract 1 from the result, which means that this is our result, and we subtract 1 from it. The next part of the question says, evaluate both expressions using x equals 2. So let's start off with the first expression, expression number 1. So we're going to put 2 in there. So we get 2 bracket 1 minus 3 plus 2 and parentheses and bracket. So of course we're going to do what's in parentheses first, or inside the bracket and in parentheses first. So that is 2, 1 minus 5, and then 1 minus 5, as we know, once we do keep change, change, is 2 times negative 4, which gets us negative 8. For the other expression, what we have to write, using the original one, is, and substituting 2 in for x, is 2. 3 plus 2 minus 1. Again, we're going to do what's in parentheses first, so therefore it is 2 times 5 minus 1, because 3 plus 2 is 5. 2 times 5 is 10, minus 1 using order of operations, and then 10 minus 1 is 9. Here it says, what's the difference between subtract the result from 1 and subtract 1 from the result? Well, the difference is the order that it says it. Notice how this says the result from 1 and 1 from the result. It's just flipping those two. And as a result, we have to flip those two. So here, anything that comes after the word from is actually happening first inside our algebraic expression. Thus, whatever comes from after the word from has to come first in the algebraic expressions, thus subtracting. Subtract the result from 1 results in 1 minus the result, while the subtract 1 from the result is the result minus 1. This matters because the order in subtraction is important, and that the subtraction is not commutative, essentially meaning that 5 minus 3 is not the same thing as 3 minus 5. Therefore, these two things, 1 minus the result and the result minus 1, are not the same thing.